Hi, I'm Martin from Tyk. If you haven't heard about us, Tyk is an open source API gateway and API management platform that is fast, easy to use, and has a friendly and intuitive user interface. In this video, I'd like to tell you about our new Kubernetes Ingress controller. We think it's pretty cool. I want to tell you all about it. To assume you already know what Kubernetes is and what an ingress controller does. But if you don't, here's the cliff notes. Kubernetes is an ever-growing, cloud-conquering container orchestration system that large and small companies alike use to deliver their APIs and services to users. One of the first things folks want to do when they start on the Kubernetes journey is look for a way to get traffic from the outside of their cluster into their services. For that, we would use something called an ingress. And ingresses are controlled by an ingress controller. So far, so simple. The interesting thing is there's a lot of choice out there when it comes to how you bring traffic from the outside in. For a lot of people, their requirements are as simple as just making sure the connections are encrypted. But for most, there's a bunch of extra things you want to be looking for, such as authentication, rate limiting, and of course, encryption. And that's where Tyk comes in. As I mentioned earlier, Tyk is a platform that is designed to securely manage and secure traffic from the outside of your network to the inside. Whether you're using Kubernetes, a standard Amazon account, or your own server in a data center somewhere, Tyk will work anywhere. What we've done here, though, is make Tyk work especially well with the workflows and practices that come with using Kubernetes, in particular, Kubernetes ingresses. With the Tyk ingress controller, you simply specify your ingress using a standard specification, then add an annotation to tell the Tyk controller to do something with this ingress. When you push the ingress to Kubernetes, as if by magic, your service will be available to the outside world. What's interesting here is that when you create this ingress, Tyk automatically generates a route for your service in its API list, and it also sets some defaults, such as not adding any rate limiting, and adding a request ID so you can track requests as they pass through your cluster. However, you probably want to secure this service, so first off, you'll want to add an Ssl certificate to encrypt the connection. And then, you'll want to make sure that only authorized users can actually use your services, and only use them within certain boundaries. Let's start with the first problem, adding an Ssl certificate. To get the Ssl certificate into Kubernetes, you create something called a secret, and then you reference that secret in a special TLS section in your ingress specification. When you push your ingress, Tyk will automatically make a copy of that certificate and load it up for you. Easy as pie. Now for the second requirement, protecting the service with an access token, we can do it two ways. First off, we could just go into the dashboard, select the token security option in the API, and save the service. That service will now be protected, and you don't need to do anything else. However, if you go and delete that ingress, or it changes, then those settings might get overwritten and lost, which isn't great for making sure your infrastructure is easy to use, tear down, and recreate. One of the main use cases for Kubernetes is to keep as much of your infrastructure as code as possible. With the Tyk ingress controller, you can also set any variable in the Tyk API definition, that's the options that make up how a service is handled by the Tyk gateway, using special annotations in the Kubernetes specification. Now, to make our ingress work as if it's protected by an authentication token, all we need to do is set the correct values in the definition to true. In this case, it's a field called useDefaultAuth and useKeylessAuth. We will set the first to true and the second to false using the special Tyk Boolean annotation modifiers. When this definition is pushed into the cluster, Tyk will set these options for you in the generated API definition and make it live. And then, hey, presto, bingo, you've got yourself a token authenticated service that you can set up and tear down using your Kubernetes files. There's a few more cool things you can do with this ingress, which you can see in our documentation or on our website, www.tyk.io, or in some of our other videos about this topic. Thanks for watching, and happy hacking!